I'm Kenneth Leaner, and this is Free Kicks Outside, where it's always stick 30, and it's always time to get outside. Well, not today, anyway. Today, we're still inside from the previous video. I was going to talk to you about being safe in the woods and having overall camp safety. And this is part one in that series. I just want to start off with a discussion. If I can talk today, it'd be nice. Everybody seems to know about deadfall. Of course, you got animals, which can cause you a problem. How you just set your camp up can be a problem. And again, you also got cutting hazards, chopping hazards. Any tool you use, you got a hazard with that. But putting all that type of safety aside, there's one thing that a lot of the bushcrafters out there aren't, survivalists, or just people in general, are not talking about, and that's people. That's right, people. Contrary to popular belief, but most people are relatively evil. You don't know who's going to attack you out of nowhere. I mean, which is today's society, the way things are, you know, if you don't believe in guns, that's your deal. As I said in a previous video with one of my non-gun video, because my gun was broke. But anyway, that got me thinking about quite a bit of stuff here. A lot of people just don't think about other people in the woods. I mean, you see them there, you pass them there, and you don't really give them a second thought. But maybe you should start really, really keeping your eyes open for this type of stuff. Because it's only next news story that could be you. I mean, if you really want to get into it. It could be just a couple of guys out for having a good old swell time. And, well, Tiffany just was too provocatively dressed. And she shouldn't have been there. Yeah, right. Because some punk-ass drunks couldn't contain themselves. Tiffany got raped. Let's put it in that terminology. Knowing how to defend yourself, period, is very important. Whether you're in the woods or in the streets. Self-defense is something that everyone should probably get at least an idea of how to do. Do I mean go out and take a class on Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu? I mean, if you really, really want to, I guess go ahead. But, you know, me personally, I really don't need it. I know how to defend myself. And if it comes down to a hand-to-hand combat situation where I'm going to have to fight you, it's going to be you or me, and I'm going to pick me. I don't care what you got going on. I don't want to know your background story. I'm going to take you out because it's you or it's me, and I'm choosing me because I'm going home to my family tonight, if that's really where you want to go with that. But also, anymore, you know, I'm not 20 anymore. I mean, my body's, it's had its fair share of beat-ons, as I should say. And, well, being a redneck, well, you got to be tough. Or smart, and now I'm a smart, tough redneck. But I'm also had a long life of being a redneck and getting the hell beat out of me. I got a shoulder, it's messed up. Knees ain't quite what they once used to be. You know, I got degenerative disc disease. One eye's about useless. And people that know me knows I got, you know, some other issues. You know, outside of those issues, I'm in perfect health. No high cholesterol, no high blood pressure, diabetes, any of that stuff. I'm cherry. But going back to it and getting back to the real focus of what this video is about is being in generalized safety. Now, usually your first line of defense is going to be what you can see. If you see somebody coming toward you, you know, it's nothing to slow down. Stop, take your pack off, get your water out, take you a little drink and let them pass you and make sure they stay past you. If not, well, I will show you a nice little safety trick later in this series on how to defend yourself with a water bottle and your pack, if it comes to that. Personally, I like a stainless steel water bottle, and make sure you get a stainless steel water bottle if it's nothing else but to carry water in, unless you got some sort of weird allergy. But I like stainless steel water bottle with stainless steel top. Needless to say, you have a blunt force trauma object with X amount of water still in it to add to its weight. But most people think, well, I got a knife. Oh, that's nice. You got a knife. Do you know how to use that knife? When you throw tools as weaponry into a mix of something, if you do not know how to properly use it, then, well, you're better off just not having it. Because in the end, they could take it away. If they know more than you, they can take it away from you, and it gets used on you. Same principle with the gun. If you're afraid to use it, then it's probably going to get used on you. My new teacup. Anyway. You know, we carry into the woods a variety of different tools and stuff. Oh, let me just pick one of these puppies up. And we'll use this one. This here is an actual defense knife. Now, because it cut hollow grind, false hollow grind here, which is hollow grind to the point, but don't have no sharp edge on it. It comes down to a nice point. This is defensive knife. This is not a buck knife or to be confused with anything else. This is actually a defensive knife. I can use it for bushcrafting because I know how to use the knife. So, but, I'll keep this up for a minute. But to put it in perspective with an actual bushcrafting knife, this is what I got to build new scales for. You can pretty much tell the difference between the two tips. This one's more rounded. This one isn't. This is designed to stab somebody. This is designed more for cutting. Keep that in mind. If you don't know really what you want in a knife, go to an expert. I mean, go to a gun store or like Dick's Sporting Goods, or just, you know, try your own out and see what you find that works best for you in the lines of a knife. But for a self-defense standpoint on it, I mean, take you some self-defense classes. Right? There's nothing wrong with being prepared for it. I mean, I know there's a lot of people out there that's going to be, well, if you go looking for trouble, you're going to find it. I ain't looking for it. I just want to be prepared when it comes. Being prepared and knowing how to defend yourself falls under the same principle as a condom. It's better to have it and not need it than need it and not have it. I prefer to be prepared, personally. So that's entirely up to you. You don't believe in knives? Well, how the hell are you going to be able to do anything with that? Because I'm sure there's going to be somebody somewhere who's going to say, well, I just don't believe in knives. Knives are bad. How are you going to whittle, cut wood, or do anything in the woods without a knife of some degree? Anyway, I suppose nature also always provides you with a nice whacking stick. I mean, sucker will do a little bit of damage here. Put a little loop through it and carry it on your side. That's why I also like walking sticks. They're not just for just walking along the woods with them, blah, 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 blah. You can also defend yourself with them. If you take a class on self-defense with a staff weapon, that would be a best choice in that aspect of it. Because a lot of people like to carry, you know, a walking stick or, you know, a staff with them while they're in the woods. And they do serve multiple purposes. So, you know, it's a nice, easy blend and mix there. But, yeah. Do a pocket knife as a self-defense weapon? Well, let's take a look at that as an aspect. You got this clipped to your belt. I mean, you have to reach down here, pull it out, open it up, then defend yourself with it. Not very effective compared to a actual locked solid tanged knife like this. This is actually a skinning knife for, you know, bucks and fish or whatever other animal. This sucker is designed to cut and slice and dice, and it will do the job. It's not really designed for stabbing people or anything, but if you want to cut something up, this sucker will do the job real quick and easy. That's what it's for. So know what your knives are built for. That's important. Got a dog coming across.
Hold on a second.
These little fold-up knives, I mean, they're okay. If you need to use something like that, I'm going to test this one out and get around to it yet. An actual pocket knife, which this one here is for a project I'm getting ready to start later on. And videotape, of course. They got even littler little pocket knives. Something like that. I mean, that'll do a little niceness. I mean, if you as a kid or just need a small pocket knife, this here will work pretty good for you. I mean, ain't you bad. But I don't like knives that don't have that little lip on it on the guard to protect your finger. Because if you don't go to do something, you could slip off of it and hit that blade. Personally, I like to have a little something between me and the blade to some degree on that aspect. Now, I got what I call the three-step rule in self-defense. If something can get to you within 3 steps, and I mean that's basically a yardstick, 3 quick steps, that is your area of close quarters combat. This is as close as you're going to get. 3 steps and they're on top of you. That's where you need to be able to defend yourself, is in that area. Now, there's steps you can take before you get to that area, but being able to take care of yourself in that 3-step area is very important. And I'll go into all that later, along with the rest of the knives and weaponry, because, I mean, heck, you got all kinds of nifty things you can carry with you all the time. You can carry one of these kukadrays. And if you're going to have a weapon, like I said, any weapon of any kind, know how to use it properly. This sucker is designed to kill. Take off limbs, heads, mangle, chop. It does it. A lot of people don't think that way, but that's what this knife was specifically designed for. Works well as a chopping replacement for an axe, if that's what you want to bring with you in. You know, if you're concerned about weight and need something to chop wood and stuff with, this kukure is a very good option for that purpose, too. But you can also take a class at, I mean, there should be some sort of, like, a martial arts studio or someplace that can offer classes on how to defend yourself with knives and different weaponry to some degree. And sometimes you can get free classes at your YMCA or other organizations, and just look around on Facebook and see if you can't find something there. I personally don't have them that information at this time. But, you know, if you got some information, throw it in the comments. Let people see it. I mean, and one day we'll go back and we'll revisit the sachete. But right now, I mean, if this is what you're carrying with you in the woods, machete itself is pretty dang straightforward. It is not designed to stab anything. It's designed to chop, hack, and cut. That's just a straight-up hacking device. As long as you can swing this sucker and keep a hold of it, you pretty well got yourself covered there. I mean, so, yeah. But still, always try to figure out a best way to defend yourself from other people, because people in themselves aren't the most dangerous things that's in the woods. So we'll probably continue this in a later video when I get more in depth with a bunch of other things. But that is just our general topic of, you know, self-defense. I usually like to think of self-defense as a 3-level setup. 4 if you count when you first see somebody. You know, trust your gut instinct. If something's telling you that something ain't right, 9 times out of 10, something ain't right. Keep your wits about you there on that one. So you get your long range, which is your far long range. So when you first get in your sight, that's when you go, okay, what are you going to do? And then see, when you get within like 30 paces is more or less your long range area. They can come at you pretty quick. They're acting weird and odd. They're usually going to do that the closer they get to you. So 30 paces, you're going to start thinking, hmm. So from 30 to 15 paces there, you got something ain't quite right. Well, I'm going to stop and keep an eye on this fella. So that way, in that time, you take your pack off, stop, take your drink, you get your water out and stuff like that, and just be prepared for whatever. And then watch it pass. You got your closer range, anything 15 feet, you know, 15 paces, which is roughly yardage, give or take. I mean, it just depends on how you look at it. I don't know how big your steps are, but so when I'm talking about three steps or paces, I'm talking about a large step, which is usually about a yard. So three quick steps be basically 3 yards. So when they're in that 15 pace to 15 yard range, that's when you really want to get your mindset of, okay, what are you going to do? Do I need to start getting prepared to fight? Because when they're in the 10 yard range, that'd be your best bet for a gun. Or if you get them backed off to that point, then you want to pull out a gun and go, hey, you know, this, keep the hell away from me. Most of your fighting and conflict is going to happen within the 5 to 3 paces range. So 5 yards to 3 yards. That's where majority of your contact is going to come. So if you can keep an eye on them from afar, know they're there, and be aware of them. And as they get closer, just kind of prepare yourself to take a feel of the situation and find out, if do I need to be prepared to fight? Or is everything just going to be on kosher? Now, the safety rule, that should be followed if you're new to going into the woods, and especially if you're starting in bushcrafting and things like that, especially if you're a woman. Not saying women are any weaker than anybody else, or can't do things that anybody else can do. Don't get that confused. Because I know quite a few women that can kick a lot of ass. So, just keep that in mind. Now, not everybody's a Ronda Rousey, of course. But, when you come into a situation where you're going to be going into the wilderness, and you know you're going to stay there for a period of time, or you're just practicing or whatever, have a group with you. You know, get a couple friends together, so the more of you there is, the less likely there's going to be any problems with anybody. Just in general. So, safety's in numbers, as they always say, and well, that's usually your best bet. That's really the first safety tip I got for anyone that's a woman. And, well, I'll dive into more of that later. But, in the end, that's just a generalized conversation of what's going on there with my safety, you know, self-defense kind of video. And it really is something that needs to be addressed. You know, because you do not know what's going to come on at you in the outside world. I mean, where I'm at, are we going to be attacked by lions and bears? Probably not. But there's coyotes, timber wolves, rattlesnakes, you know, and mainly people. So you never know what you might walk up on. I like to have something with me to protect myself regardless. Because you never know what you are going to walk up on or who you're going to run into. And somebody could just have an episode. Who knows? Defend yourself. Plain and simple. I'll continue this on in 2 of the safety video. So we'll just cover more of that there in the second part of this. I don't know how many parts it's going to be, but I just want to make sure I run through the entirety of safety on this stuff. You know. Now, until next time, I'm Ken Slater, and this is Free Kicks Outside, where it's always stick 30, and it's always time to get outside. So come on, get outside already.